Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Dr. Nambin, your medical doctor, catering for all your health needs. Today we're just gonna be talking about breast cancer, your symptoms, what are the signs, what to look for, the risk factors, and also what, you know, investigations can you do, and most importantly, how do you examine at home and check for any signs of cancer, so on the breast. So I will see you in a bit. If you haven't subscribed on my YouTube channel, please like, comment, and subscribe, and follow my journey as I continue to touch on, you know, health related matters that, you know, will be able to change your life forever. Hang in, stay tuned as we continue to discuss this topic.
Take me away from home. Show me all the places I've never known. And we'll chase the night. Race all of the.
Welcome back to my channel. So today we're just gonna be discussing about breast cancer. If you don't know that much about breast cancer, from the statistics point of view, at least one in every 10 women presents with your breast cancer. Hence, it's very important that we discuss about breast cancer, the symptoms, the signs, investigations, how to do your own self-examination to check for breast cancer at the comfort of your own home. So let's just dig in right into the topic of breast cancer. So breast cancer, because it's so common, I have personally seen it in my family. I have seen patients coming to my surgery where we just, you know, send them for workup, and it came that it's a malignant cancer. So for that reason, that's why it's important that we need to touch on the topic of your breast cancer. So importantly, the first thing I want to concentrate on is what are the signs or the symptoms of your breast cancer. Number one, as a woman, you might present that with a breast mass, or what we call a breast lump. So you feel around your breast and you feel suddenly there's something that is growing there that probably wasn't there before, and that is the first sign that this can be a benign lesion, which benign usually means maybe it's non-cancerous type of cancer, or it can be a malignant type of lesion or mass. Malignant just means it's a cancerous type of mass or a cancerous type of, you know, lump. So please be able to check that out, because that's the most important sign that we see in women, and that's the commonest sign that makes the woman come to consult, because they have, you know, seen something that is just irregular on their breast. Point number two is, you know, there's a nipple invasion. So nipple, instead of being straight, so the nipple suddenly drops down. So look for that sign. If you see your nipple was usually straight, so, and suddenly your nipple is down, that is not a good sign. Go to your doctor and have it checked out. For some, it's usually a discharge on the nipple that doesn't want to end. It's just consistent, it keeps on coming, and the smell of that discharge is actually very bad. So look out for that sign. Some, they actually present with a breast pain that doesn't go away. So also, if the breast pain doesn't go away, go and check it out and see if this breast pain and the nipple discharge is actually related to any type of cancer that, you know, you might have. So as you can see on the video, you might see an orange, and you might ask yourself, why is Dr. Nambi holding an orange? Yes, it's weird, but that is also one of the commonest signs as doctors that we look out for cancer. So we call it, it's a skin change, and the name that we use it, forgive me for my pronunciation, but it is powdery orange type of, you know, appearance. So you see the type of skin appearance of the orange. You see those dimples there? Basically, you see that on your breast. You know, instead of having a nice and very smooth, you know, nipple, then you see these things all over your nipple, that skin changes is not normal. So if you can just put next to your breast and you check and you compare and you can see, but my breast is looking like this orange. Please quickly also rush to your doctor so that your doctor can check it and confirm if it's really the powdery orange or the skin color, the skin changes of an orange appearance, because that is the biggest, you know, change that we see, and that can also help us to make the diagnosis if it's a cancer or if it's non-cancer. So look out for that. So it's the lumps that you'll be able to see, it's discharges, nipple pain, nipple invasion, instead of being straight it's actually maybe dropping down, and the skin changes that looks like an orange appearance. If you see that, that's a danger sign, quickly run to your doctor. Your doctor will confirm and they will be able to, you know, do the proper investigation to make sure they make the diagnosis of a cancer. The next thing is the risk factor. So you might ask yourself, so what are the risk factors? So the fact that you are a woman already, that's a risk factor, you know, for, you know, for getting breast cancer. So being female, having number two, family history of breast cancer in the family, that puts you as a woman at risk. We have seen also women that, you know, start your menstruation early, it puts them at risk of, you know, having breast cancer. Women that go on menopause, very late, also that puts you at risk also, you know, for getting, you know, breast cancer later in life. We have women that don't have children. We have women that, you know, actually have children, but maybe one child, and they have this child very late, you know, maybe after 35 years of age, and, you know, so with the advanced age, that obviously also has a big impact and causes a big risk on, you know, your chances of getting your breast cancer. The contraception is debatable, so I'm not gonna touch on your contraception and how it affects, you know, your chances of you getting breast cancer or not getting breast cancer. And also, I just wanted to mention part of also the risk factors. This is more common in men. We also have men that develop, you know, breasts, and in this condition, we actually call it medical term, we call it gynecomastia. So if you also see there's a man with, you know, fully developed breast, that can be gynecomastia. And also we have men that, you know, when you feel, you can actually feel there's a lump in that breast. So also take it serious when you see a man with a lump in the breast. The first thing we usually want to know is your medical history. What medication are you taking? We know certain medications can predispose, you know, the man to actually be at risk of developing gynecomastia. We know, you know, some ARVs or antiretroviral medication that can cause gynecomastia or breast developing in men. We have also seen some medications like digoxin. We have seen your cimetidine, which is anti-ulcer medication, also puts, you know, men at risk of developing, you know, your gynecomastia. And obviously men who are on hormonal treatment, they are also at risk of, you know, developing breast. So those are the things to take note of if you are men and you are just in on my channel and you are listening to this topic. Please don't click out, because this topic is also important for you, because you will help also your partner, you will help yourself so that you can make that diagnosis. You can help your family member, your sisters, your mothers. When you hear they are talking about lumps or masses or any discharges, you can quickly interfere and say, let's go to the doctor and have this checked out. So your common investigations that are done, usually we do, especially if there's a lump that has been confirmed, we want to do a core biopsy. So the biopsy will be able to tell us if this cancer is a benign, or this lump is a benign, or if it's a malignant, you know, type of cancer. Benign is just not Benign is usually just removed and that's the end of it. But if it's malignant, usually they will refer you for chemotherapy. So just be, you know, be advised that even if let's say there's a lump, the treatment might differ, depends on what they get, if it's a malignant or non-malignant. So if it's non-malignant, it's very good, which is benign. If it's malignant, then it's usually not so good. You will need to go for chemotherapy or, you know, cancer reducing medication that the doctors might prescribe for you to reduce this mass so that it can come down. And then, so the other thing also is a mammography. Mammography is just an investigation. It's like, it's an x-ray that is dedicated for the breast. So you just go there, they take an x-ray on this portion, and that will be able to help you to make the diagnosis of a breast cancer or now breast cancer. And so those are the most common, you know, most common investigations. Treatment is obviously, if it's non-malignant or if it's benign, they will just do a surgical operation and remove that lump. And usually you keep on rechecking and see if this thing comes back. If it comes back, go to the doctor immediately, they'll check again. But if the lump or the mass comes and they say it's malignant, then it's usually chemotherapy, or they will give you medication that is able to tackle, you know, your cancer. So that's the treatment. So let's go to the most exciting part that I love, which is breast examination. So your breast examination, you as a man, you can help your partner by doing the breast examination. If you are a woman, also you can do it on yourself. You don't really necessarily have to wait for your partner or your husband to check you. You can do this at the comfort of your home before you even go to the doctor, so that by the time you go to the doctor, you can be specific and tell your doctor, I've seen something, it's on the left or the right or the up or the down. Then it helps us to be, you know, specific when we are checking, and we know, okay, let's go in and check for what the patient has presented. So breast examination, obviously I can't demonstrate otherwise I'm gonna go nude and I can't do that. So so obviously you need to remove your shirt off, you remove your bra off. So we just want to see the breast. Ideally stand in front of your mirror. So look straight in your mirror. Let me say I'm standing so, upright position, and then you check. Are you seeing, you know, the breasts are on the same level? Do you see the symmetry? I remember when we were doing medicine, I think it was orthopedics block, they always used to teach us look, feel, and move. So the first thing you need to do is to look. So you're gonna look. What do you see? Are you seeing the same? Because the body, the way it's created, what you see on the left is what you see on the right. So that's what we call symmetry. Is this breast looking exactly the same as this one? So you check at the symmetry and you are standing upright, looking straight in your mirror. And then if you are happy, you can even put your hands on the waist, stand upright and check. Are you seeing the same? But remember, you are watching and you are looking in your mirror to see if you are seeing the same. Then once you do that, the other thing is to put your hand behind you and to imagine that your breast is actually, your breast is actually the clock. So you will just take your three fingers, you go up here. So you start at the top, or is it 12 o'clock? I think so. You start at 12 o'clock, so you go at 3 o'clock, and then you go at 6 o'clock, and then you go at 9 o'clock, and then you come back at 12 o'clock. So while you are doing that, you are actually feeling for any masses. Remember, you use the opposite hand, the first three fingers, the palmar aspect, and then the middle finger, sorry. Then you check and see if there's any irregularities. While you are doing that also, you can come close to your nipple line so you can see when you are pressing, is there any discharge that is coming around the nipple? And then don't forget your axillary tail, because we know the lymph drainage of, you know, your breast is usually around this area on the axilla. So also be able to feel up to there. Once you are done, you change your hands. Remember, back of your head, three fingers, and then start at 12 o'clock up here. Then you go checking, feeling, and then you reach 6 o'clock. You come down, you reach 9 o'clock. Don't forget your axillary tail, or just under your armpit. And then you come down to 12 o'clock. Don't forget again around the nipple, just to see when you're pushing if anything is coming out. So you do it while standing, then you can do it while lying, so that you can see if there's any difference. In case when you are standing, there's something that you miss. So when you're lying down, then you can be able to pick up anything. We also recommend you do this while you are showering. You can ask your partner to palpate or feel if there's anything irregular in your breast. If you feel something, if you feel a lump, you know, let's say you just checked today and then you feel something doesn't really sit well. You know, after 1 week, this thing that you are feeling, is it changing? Is it getting bigger or is it getting smaller? If it's getting bigger, that's a sign that maybe this might be a cancer. So don't delay to seek medical advice. I know it's scary. When we talk about cancer, it's very scary, but early detection means, you know, early survival rate and the chances of you, you know, being, you know, cancer free is very high. But if you go late to check this out, then the chances of survival, they are very, very slim. So that's it on your medical tips from Dr. Nambi, focusing on breast cancer. If you do have any questions, any comments, any experiences, any family member that you know that have gone through this, that you want to take this opportunity to also share your advice, please share and comment down below on my page. And don't forget to like, to subscribe, and share this video to somebody that will need the help, that will need, you know, the encouragement to make the first step, to be able to go and check themselves out and then go and seek medical advice. This is Dr. Nambi with your weekly medical tips, house tips, health advices. Thank you for coming on my YouTube channel. I will see you next week with the next medical, you know, topic.